My name is Risma Walisiahaan. I was a student at the Indonesian Adventist University and I 17 years old. Now, I will share the story of my life since the pandemic came to this moment. And in my story, the topic I chose was how the pandemic affect the lives, emotion, and studies. I hope everyone can understand what I say about my story life and be useful. When I first heard of this coronavirus, I was still in the dormitory. At the time, I was not afraid because I did not fully understand the disease. So I am with my friends in the dormitory still relaxing. But as time went by, all the boarding children were sent home as the Singkawang grew more and more. We get message from the teacher to take care of themselves. Long story short, I arrived at home and I'm happy to see my family. The casualties grow by the day and yet I to keep calm because by not worrying, it wasn't easy to hit. That was in my understanding. I was so bored at home. When I woke up doing my chores, I was cooking, eating, bathing, playing, watching, and others. Just like I do every day at home, because it scares the hell out of me. But thinking of my mother, who was a good cook, I thought of learning how to bake a cake with my mother. Everything I saw on television was easy, I tried with my mom. Incidentally, my family enjoyed eating and a piece of cake. We had tried various cakes in spite of setbacks, starting with sweet tarts, peanut brittle, and so on. It was one of the experiences I had when the pandemic came, how the pandemic affect my life with activity. But I used to be bad at home, but even since the pandemic was home, I could bake a cake. One time, my mother was watching the news on the television. There was a view of how more and more people were exposed to the coronavirus. Plus, anybody that was to be buried had to be an officer in health protocol alone to bury it, and that upset the family. Then, there was also news that locals didn't receive corpses for fear of being infected with the coronavirus. They have come to plead and people refused to release their emotion. I thought there was nothing wrong with the body until it was turned down so hard. Just stay away, for sure not to catch it. From my experience watching the news on the television, I also realized that this pandemic has an effect of person's emotion that easily overflow. I had to go to Java when college was about to start. Since the current study system had to be good, while it was hard to get good service at home, I went with this to me. And my father gave me message that we must stay cool as cucumber and must take care. After we arrived in Java, we had to be careful because we heard that the central Java had already been listed as an area where the as red as a cherry was infected with the coronavirus. When I start following my college meeting, was very sad because I could not be directly at my friend with a lecture as well, but rather through online and Zoom application. Moreover, sometimes the handphone I use sometimes errors, so to follow the class and collect the task is blocked. There is a difficulty I've experienced during online learning. Not even just me, but my other friends also and difficulty in learning online. From the experience I experienced, it appears that this pandemic brings that influence in the field of education. Well, Here's the story of my life experience during this pandemic, where we can conclude that as it affects life, emotion, and education. Thank you.